my channel Asfia's Tutorial. Dear students, thanks a lot for the feedback that you have given me. Let's start today with some more important preposition. So let's start with the word compare. Compare, sometimes we use preposition with and sometimes we use preposition to with the word compare. So see the differences. When we compare two similar things, then we use the preposition with. Suppose in a sentence like this, we often compare Raghunath Chaudhary with William Wordsworth. So here there is similarity between Raghunath Chaudhary and William Wordsworth. Yes, William Wordsworth is a poet of nature in English literature. On the other hand, Raghunath Chaudhary is poet of nature, nature poet in Assamese literature. So there is a similarity between Raghunath Chaudhary and William Wordsworth. So we use the preposition with. But when we compare two dissimilar things, then we use the preposition to. In a sentence like that, we often compare anger to fire. So fire is different thing and anger is different thing, but we find some similarity between the two. So when we compare two dissimilar things, then we use the preposition to. Okay, then in the second word, I want to discuss with direction. Okay, in direction, we use three prepositions generally, in and on and to. In a sentence like that, China is dash the north of India. Now here we have to use the preposition to. China is to the north of India. Why we use the preposition to? Because China is out of India. So when it is outside the boundary, then we use the preposition to. If it is inside the boundary, then we use the preposition in. Suppose Delhi is, okay, Delhi is in the north of India. And because Delhi is inside the boundary of India, so we use the preposition in. If it is on the border, then we have to use the preposition on. Suppose the Himalayas are on the north of India. Okay, when it is in the boundary, then we have to use the preposition on. If it is outside the boundary, then we have to use the preposition to. And if it is inside the boundary, then we use the preposition in. Yes, I hope you can follow me. Then last but not least, the preposition that I want to discuss now is, it is the verb apply. So very often we use preposition to and with the verb apply. So when we have to use to and with, okay, or for, let's see. So when we apply for a particular post, then we use the preposition for. Yes, I am going to apply for the post of teacher. Yes, apply for the post of teacher. So when the post is mentioned, then we have to use the preposition for. On the other hand, in a sentence like, suppose I am going to apply to the principal. Yes, so I am going to apply to the principal. To the principal for the post of English teacher. So when a person is there, so you have to write two preposition. Yes, so I am going to apply to the principal for the post of English teacher. So I hope you can follow me, and that's all for today. I hope the preposition that I have been teaching you, it will be very instrumental for your speaking and writing as well. Okay, meet you soon in the next video. Till then, bye and keep safe.